guys, it's Kim Dao here. Welcome back to my channel. It's that time of the year again for prom. Last year I made a couple of videos where I tried on prom dresses and a lot of you guys found that really useful, so I am doing that again this year. I picked out 5 dresses from YesStyle. Most of them are under $100, so I'm going to be giving you guys my honest review on what they are like in person. I'm also going to be comparing the dresses to the photos YesStyle uses to advertise the dress to see if what you see online is actually what you get in person. Just before I start this video, if you guys haven't yet, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of these YesStyle reviews and also I like to buy stuff on websites to compare them and stuff like that. I also make a lot of Japan travel videos and also Korea ones as well. So yeah, subscribe if you're interested in that stuff and let's start the video. First off, I'm going to be telling you guys the size I usually wear so you guys can use it as a reference. So I usually wear a size extra small, that is a size 6 in Australia. First is this off the shoulder evening gown. This one was $97.59. I got this in blue in a size small. Comparing to the photo, I think it does look the same. However, in this lighting, the color of the dress looks a little bit different. So it looks a bit lighter on camera, but in the photo it looks a little bit darker. That's the only difference I see. But in terms of everything else, yeah, it looks the same. My first impression when I put on this dress, I really liked it. I think it looks really nice, really flattering. Also, the quality is really good for the price. I'm going to move closer so you guys can see more detail of the dress. As you can see, it's off the shoulder and you've got these elastic straps over here to just hold the dress up, which I really like. Whenever I wear off the shoulder tops or dresses, I get really paranoid that the dress would fall down, but with the sleeves here, it's actually really tight, so that's not going to happen. I really like the detailing of the dress. All the flowers are sewn on, so they're not glued, which is great because when they're glued on, I find that they fall off very easily. But this one, I feel like it's stuck on pretty well. Sizing wise, I think this one fits me perfectly. So I usually wear a size extra small, like I said. This one's a size small, but at the back you can be quite flexible with your sizes. So I tied it quite tight. However, there's still quite a lot of room for me to breathe in, so it's very comfortable wearing this dress. That's the most important thing. You need to be comfortable for the night. I love how flowy this dress is. It's really easy and comfortable to walk around in. The dress has a few layers, so you've got the first layer right here, then you've got another layer of the same material, then underneath you've got like a satin kind of material, and there's only one layer of that. Yeah, so that's just to make your dress look a bit more shiny underneath. For the length of this dress, it's actually not that bad. So if I wear heels, so I'll be a little bit more taller, I'm wearing no shoes right now. Yeah, I think it would be perfect actually. So I forgot to tell you guys my height. I am 155 centimeters, so you guys can convert that to whatever measurements you use. I am short, so usually with dresses I have to get them altered, otherwise I would just trip and fall over. But for this one, I think it's perfect. I love it. Size fits nicely, looks like the photo. It's beautifully made, very comfortable to wear, so I recommend this one. Next, I got this short dress with a long train. This one was $107.93 and I got it in a size extra small. The problem with the lighting I've got in front of me is like there's light literally shining at me, so the dress looks a bit lighter than the actual photo, but in real life I think the color looks exactly the same. My first impressions when I put on this dress, I thought it was very stunning, so beautiful, really well made, but the train is a lot longer than I expected, and for prom I think it's a bit too excessive. I think if the train was maybe just touching the ground, that would look a lot nicer, but the fact that it's so long, it just kind of reminds me of a wedding dress. For photo shoots, I think it would be absolutely stunning, but just wearing it out, a lot of people are going to be stepping on that dress. For the size, I think it fits me perfectly. It's like the other dress as well, where you can just tie it as tight or as loose as you want. It's really comfortable to wear, even though it is a strapless dress. It sits very well on my waist, so I don't think it's going to be moving around anywhere. Now let's move up to see the close-ups. This is a close-up of the dress, and as you can see, it's really beautifully made. The only complaint I have is that the flowers, they are all glued onto the dress. I've gotten a few dresses from YesStyle in the past, and whenever flowers are glued onto the dress, I find that they fall off a lot easier. But I just want to show you guys the skirt part because I think it's made so well. So the skirt part is very puffy, and I do have a few short dresses from YesStyle where the skirt was supposed to be puffed out like this, but it did not look like this at all, and that's just because the quality just wasn't good. But this one here is actually amazing because it's got layers of material inside, and it's got one layer of tulle, and this is just satin materials. So combining all that together, your dress is always puffy, which I really like. The train is really well made as well. So all right, I was actually thinking I could maybe alter the dress to make the train a bit shorter, but the way the dress is made, it's actually quite hard to do so because the train is made exactly the same way as the skirt. So there's multiple layers of material inside the train. It's got a layer of, I think this is organza, and I'm not sure what this material is. It feels very soft, like satin, but it's not. And there are more layers inside which I can't actually get to. You can tell it's really sturdy and it wouldn't, you know, rip very easily. Overall, in terms of the quality and how well it is made, I'm gonna give this one a thumbs up. I don't know if I will be able to wear this dress out, but I think if I was having a photo shoot, this dress would be perfect. It's just that the train is way too long for my liking to go out in, and because I am short, I guess that's why it looks a lot longer. I think if you were tall though and you wore this dress, this would look stunning on you. So I think it's more suited towards tall people. Next, we got this short dress for $58.89. I got this one in a pink in a size extra small. So first, comparing to the photo, it looks exactly the same, so I'm very happy about that. I think that it looks good. However, it's not very comfortable. Let me show you guys what I'm talking about. So as you can see, the dress fits me very nicely and it is quite comfortable from the waist downwards. Now up here, it's super uncomfortable because, don't know if you can see, there is this little plastic thing hanging out of the dress, poking into my skin, and it's super irritating. It's only happening on one side though. Over here it's okay. While that I am here, let's just look at the dress. So, okay, the detailing is nice. The flowers are all glued on, so once again, you have to be really careful because they can fall off easily. The fit, I think, is not bad. The straps, however, they are a little bit loose, so if I pull them up a little bit, it would look a lot better. I think when I'm walking around, this dress is fine, but when I sit down, this is when the plastic inside the dress starts poking me. The skirt part of the dress is actually quite beautiful. It puffs out really nicely. You've got some organza underneath to make it look like it's more puffy. The back part looks really cute too. So overall, I do think it is a really cute dress, but yeah, it's just very uncomfortable to wear. So even though it does look like the photo and it looks good, comfort wise, I'm gonna give this one a thumbs down because yeah, I'm not gonna be able to last a day in this dress. Next, I got this halter evening gown. This one was $69.03. Got this in a gray in a size extra small. Now guys, as soon as I put this dress on, I fell in love with it. I think this is actually my favorite dress so far, and I can definitely see myself wearing this in the future. I think it's just so elegant, and I love the gradation that the skirt has. So comparing this to the photo, I think it looks exactly the same. The halter part is quite unique. So as you can see, it's like a necklace. Now the thing is, okay, maybe the dress doesn't fit as well as I thought, because whilst I was walking around with this dress, the waist part keeps on drooping down a bit. If the dress droops down, then this necklace part also kind of droops down and then kind of digs into my skin. So that part is annoying, but it's not unbearable. I think if I made the dress a bit tighter on my waist, then I wouldn't have that issue. So comfort wise, it's not exactly 100%. Because of my height, the dress is a bit too long for me. So I think, okay, if I'm wearing heels, it's not so bad, but I still would rather if the dress was just straight. I think it kind of puffs out a bit more than I would like it to. So I think if I was to wear it, I would alter it a bit. I would cut the bottom part a little bit just so it would just touch the ground instead of just, dragging itself. So yeah, overall, I love this dress. It's one of my favorites. I loved it as soon as I put it on, so big thumbs up to this one. This is the final dress. This one was $73.63. I got this in a pink in a size extra small. So comparing this dress to the photo, I think it looks the same. However, the model is a lot more taller than me, so it looks a lot better on her than it looks on me, because the dress is above her knees and it's not as long. So for me, because I'm only 155 centimeters, I think this dress just drowns me out a lot, because the front part looks a bit longer than it should and the train part is just way too long. So for a prom, I think it's too much, but if you were taller, then it would look so much better on you. Quality wise, when I first opened up the dress, I thought it was just okay. Like, you know, it's not the greatest quality, but to be honest, like, you're only paying $63 for the dress, so you can't expect to have amazing quality. Though there are some flaws with the sequins, so let me show you. So the sequins are all sewn onto the dress, but this area here, the sequins are starting to fall out. So there's this weird gap here, which I thought looked a bit strange. The dress is made out of lots of layers of this organza material, but okay, I don't know how it looks like on camera because I can't really tell, but in person, the dress looks kind of a little bit tacky. Comfort-wise, I think it feels okay, it feels very comfortable. It's just that the sizing is just wrong for me because I'm too short for the dress to pull it off. And yeah, the quality of the material, I just don't think it looks that good. And the dress is too hard for me to walk around in because I'm too short. So overall, I think I'm gonna give this one a thumbs down. I don't see myself wearing this dress out. That is the end of this video. Thank you so much guys for watching and hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you guys are going to prom this year, I really hope you guys have a great time. Please thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also subscribe to my vlog channel because I do upload a lot of Japan and Korea travel vlogs on there. Follow me on social media, everything will be linked down below. And also comment down below what other videos you want me to make. Thank you so much for watching once again guys, I love you all and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys!